despair and worry. These two are not just emotions, these are the diseases which depletes one's body from the inside. Despair is the passive form of anger and worry is the passive form of fear. Both are equally dangerous for the well-being. A well-known disease which is a communicable disease, and that is TB, tuberculosis. Actually, it's rarely communicable. The root cause of it is sadness or worry. Researched by a committee of doctors of America. Our body is ruled by our own mind. The emotions decide our health, wealth, and in all aspects. When a person starts to overthink and doubt himself pointlessly and starts to dig all the aspects where he lacks instead of being grateful for what he already have, then these clouds of sadness and worry covers his mind. And thus, he is unable to see all the good things in life. For instance, he thinks that I am cheap, I am filthy, I am helpless, I can't overcome this or that, nobody will help me, how will I manage all the burden myself? I won't be successful in this task. If I fail to complete this, I will be facing huge loss and crisis. My life is gloomy, the planetary positions don't support me, and the list goes on. These types of thoughts not only weakens the immunity, which is responsible for fighting off any unwanted occurrences in the body, but also it weakens the willpower of the person. The person becomes dull, and his face appears as that of the late winter's moon, having no vitality and energy. The person thus loses the power to even fight smallest of the mishappening. And the person becomes easily prone to the various dangerous diseases like asthma, canker sores, blood pressure, tumor, filariasis, internal growth, and etc. And the root causes of these diseases is always the feelings of sadness. The root cause of lack of aphrodisiac or impotency is not only because of unnatural intercourse or masturbation, but the main reason of it is inferiority. Once there was a boy who visited Master's Hermitage who used to think himself impotent. Even after spending lots in his treatment, nothing could be happened and he decided to commit suicide. He also told the master that when all the doors were closed, there was only one door which was opened, and that was prostitute. He committed that sin for the first time in his life, and thus he got nervous there, started shivering, and he failed. The prostitute abused him way too much, and he believed the misconception that he is impotent. This auto-suggestion negatively impacted his organ, and he experienced nothing, just nothing. The master understood his problem and did his mental treatment. As a result, boy was retained in his normal state without any medicines, and he started living his life happily ever after. It has been observed that worry and stress turns a young person old in due time. His posture changes and bends forwards, his hair starts to fall and turns grey rapidly. The early wrinkles on the face are a clear indication and a signboard of sadness. Other symptoms of early aging are sitting with your hand supporting your head, exhaling deep breaths, sunken lips, wrinkles on forehead, eyebrows out of shape, wrinkles at the end of eyes near temples, a groan in voice. These signs are seen in a stressed person, and stress causes early aging. Stressed people anyhow deal with the ongoing turbulences in their lives, although they can't go much ahead in their life's journey, and that too without any hope and joy. They don't have that much stamina to live up to their destined age and die much sooner. And all that while, if a person catches some serious health issue, then it will act as a catalyst. There was a patient in Switzerland. His condition was critical, but as he met the doctor, he greeted the doctor in that very critical condition with a smile and told him that, "You don't worry, dear doctor. My death is way too far from me. You perform my treatment peacefully. I can't die." The doctor was mentally uplifted by his patient's words that he did his treatment with a keen interest. By God's grace, that person was healed within 3 weeks, to whom several doctors had declared his ailment as untreatable and that he will die sooner. This is the magic of being positive in every situation. Always remember, sadness can make you lose a deal you're about to win, and stress can push a lively person in the rock bottom. And a person who's a victim of both sadness and worry, they can only be saved by God. In Master's eyes, sadness is an atheism, one who becomes sad seeing sunsets and remain hopeless witnessing a dawn is an atheist. When there comes day after night, life after death, spring after autumn, rainy season after summer, joy after grief, then what's the reason that we consider our troubles a permanent thing? Here, Master says, one who thinks the anger of his mother a permanent thing and neglects to believe in her love for him is an atheist, and for his atheism he has to pay it in the form of punishment. The punishment could be disease, mourning, obstacles, jealousy, failure, and shorter life. People think that sadness comes from these ailments, but it is an illusion. Actually, these ailments originate from sadness and stress. When the world is full of ocean of possibilities, happiness, joy and abundance, then why there is a need for a person to remain sad and stressed for longer periods? Move on. Just think about a simple scenario of honeybee's hive. People extract honey from it, but the honeybee never lets despair take over her. Instead, from the very moment, she starts over again. Can't we learn something from these bees? Be it financial loss, loss of a loved one, a disease, loads of work, or any other lack. Why should we cry about these things for long? The Creator itself takes responsibilities for all of that. Just surrender completely. If we'll take a leap of faith and trust the Almighty, then we'll come to know that previously the problem which was posing as a mountain was not even as big as a grain for God. By God's grace, it happens to solve in no time. Just leave everything up to God, up to divine powers, and surrender completely. Don't consider yourself as world's father. If you do so, then people will approach you as your sons and daughters. Then you'll be sad seeing your empty pockets and that you have nothing to offer. Instead, consider yourself as a child of Mother Earth. Serve the world. Serve your purpose here on this planet. If you'll fulfill your duties and mission toward her, then you'll observe many fathers, mothers, and people will come to you to support you in your endeavors. You'll be blessed by the elders and Mother Earth especially. One who considers himself as the world's polite servant who serves his purpose never becomes disappointed and neither takes stress. To all the people who are stressed, sad or depressed, Swami Satyadev says, "Get up, annihilate despair. Look at the Supreme God. He is the focal point of life. He did not send you here on earth for nothing. Your existence matters. You do have a purpose. Soul is the most powerful element. Have a firm belief in this greater truth. This belief is divine, holy, godly belief. Through this, each and every battle can be fought immaculately. By this, your strength and inner powers will be unleashed. This world is full of hope and joy. And this joy can only be felt by these souls who are aware of their inner powers. A coward man is his own enemy. He wants to run from the problems, but he can't. He ends up adding more despair by crying. Whenever he goes, he carries this emotional baggage with him. This life is not for despair and worry. It is for work. Don't be afraid of troubles. Instead, face it like a warrior. Even if you face a loss, a huge obstacle is on the way, you don't get success, or even your health is down, still there is no reason to be sad. He who rides a horse, he falls. If today is filled with hurdles, then tomorrow will be filled of blessings and abundance. Soul is immensely powerful. Don't make your soul vulnerable. Trust it instead, and you, dear powerful beings, remove this filthy clothes of cowardice, despair and worry from your head. It doesn't suit you. Just trust that supreme power, the Almighty, and start with your duties. Walk in your path in the difficult times like a brave warrior with the head held high, because God is walking with you. If you will show courage, God will surely help you. Remember, God helps those who help themselves. So, I end this video here. We'll meet you in another motivational video. Thanks for listening to my Supreme Guru's advice.